Today, let's talk about searchable drop-down lists in Excel. I already have a video on how you can get this done. It's good for cases where you need it once in a sheet or have a central filter for your Excel report, but it can't be replicated to multiple rows. Since that's the most common request I get after people watch that video, today I'm going to address that. I'll show you an easy method you can use to replicate your searchable drop-down lists to multiple Excel rows. Let's get to it. This is where I want to create the searchable data validation lists. I want them to apply from row 5 until row 19. Basically, anywhere here, I want to be able to type in some characters, click on a drop-down, and get a list of names that include these characters. Now, this can be at the beginning, the middle, or the end. That shouldn't matter. The complete list of customers is sitting in the Master Data tab right here. In addition to their names, I also have the company they work at. Now notice this is formatted as an official Excel table, which is called Table Customer. I'm quickly going to bring you up to speed on how the original solution worked, because that solution is going to flow into our today's solution as well. So that didn't use any VBA. Instead, it used the new dynamic array formulas that are available in Excel for Office 365. The problem with that solution, though, was it only worked for a single cell. You couldn't replicate it to multiple cells. But basically, you typed in some characters, and then we used formulas to create a data validation preparation list that was later used by our drop-down list. So basically, we prepared the names here that were going to feed that data validation. So let's do that really quickly by writing out the formula. Now, I'll just work from the inside out. So the first thing I did was to search for the text that I just typed in this list here. And to do that, I used Excel's search function. So the text I'm looking for is the text that I just typed in. I'm looking for it not in one cell, but instead in the entire customer column here. Start number, where do I want to start looking? Well, I want to start looking from the first character. That's an optional argument anyhow, so close bracket, press enter. What I get is a list of errors and numbers. Wherever there's a match, I get a number. That number can be different depending on where those characters that I typed in start. So I typed in RO, in this case, it starts from the fifth character. In the other cases, it starts from the first character. And wherever I have hash value, it means it didn't find a match. So my next step was to turn these into a list of true and false values. So wherever there's a match, we're going to get a true. And wherever there isn't a match, we're going to get a false. The step after that was to filter for the true values by using the new filter function. Now the array is the list that I actually want to get back, which is a list of my customers. The next argument is the include argument. So what do I want to have included? By default, this includes anything that results into a true. I already have that outlined here. So anything that will result into true will be included in my final array. Now the last argument is if empty. So if no match was found, what do I want to get back? I'm just going to type in not found. Close bracket, press enter. That's my list. It's restricted to whatever I type in here. My end result was to get a data validation back, right? So let's set that up. Let's go to data, data validation. Instead of any value, I want a list, and I want that list to take a look at master data, D2. That's where my list starts, but I'm going to use the new dynamic array syntax, which is the syntax for spilled ranges, the hash sign. So this will give me the entire spilled range back, and then click on OK. If I click on the dropdown here, I get a list of names that include these characters. But there is one little thing I need to fix. So if I change this to L and click on this, I get an error that the value doesn't match the data validation restrictions. So there is one setting I need to adjust in my data validation to get this to work. So let's go back to data validation. Under error alert, uncheck show error alert after invalid data is entered and click on OK. Now if I type in an L and click on this, I get the list of names that include L. And if there is nothing in there and I click on the dropdown, I get the full list of names. And if there is something typed in that doesn't exist, I see not found here. All that works well, but the problem is that this data validation is only pointing to B5. How can I apply this to the next cells here? My first idea was to use dynamic named ranges. The problem that we currently have, though, is that we can't use names that use dynamic array references inside data validation. So let me quickly demonstrate that. Let's go back to RO here. Now I'm just going to reference this here. And what I'm going to do is to create a dynamic named range out of this. But just so that we can visualize it, let me take this here and paste this right here and switch this to this cell and press enter. So basically, whatever we change here, we can see our spilled range here. Okay, now what I'm going to do is to create a name out of this. Let's just fix the E5. I want to fix the E, but not the 5, because my idea would be to apply this to the other cells as well. Now let's copy this and go to formulas, name manager, and create a new name. I'm going to paste that formula in and call this DV for data validation and click on OK. That formula that I have here is now a part of a name. So if I close this, delete this, and instead replace this with DV, I get the same thing. If I change this to RO, that formula works fine. If in the next cell I would have, let's say, Miller, and I'm just gonna copy this down, and now I'm gonna move this down, okay, because imagine this is inside the data validation, it will work fine, right, without problems. So in theory, I should be able to create a data validation that uses this name. So if I go to data, go to data validation, go to settings here, list, and type in DV, click on OK, this is the error that I get. The source currently evaluates an error. Whatever you pick, it's not going to work. So then I thought, instead of using a name, how about creating different data preparation lists for each of these cells? Well, let's see how we can set that up. Let's go back to master data. Now, the problem is I can't just pull this down because this is going to be a spilled range on top of another. I mean, just see, if I just pull this down, these are going to be spilled ranges. So I can't do it like this. But what I can do is to transpose this list. So I'm going to put this inside the transpose function before I pull this down. And now I can pull this down. So as many cells, actually, as I need that data validation, I think I had 15 cells there. So let's pull these down two more. And that's now a separate data validation list for every single cell. So notice that here I get the entire list because those cells are currently empty. Now, one thing I forgot to do is to sort this as well, because it would be nice to have a sorted filtered data validation list. So I'm going to put the sort function inside there as well, so I can sort that filtered list. And let's just drag this down. Okay, so let's check all this. Let's first update the reference we're using for our first data validation list, because remember, originally, this was a fixed reference to D2. So I'm going to keep the D fixed now, but I'm not going to fix the 2. Because as I copy down the data validation, I want it to reference D3, D4, and so on. Now let's click on OK. Now that we have our first data validation set up properly, I'm going to copy this, highlight, right mouse click, paste special, and select validation, because we just want to copy the data validation list. Okay, so now let's check for Miller. I have Gary Miller. For RO, Robert Bloom. Let's say if I don't type in anything, I'm going to get the complete list. And if I start typing like ST and then click on this dropdown, I get the list of names that include the word ST. Right? So that data validation list is going to work on all of these cells. Now, one last bonus formula is to get the company once we have selected the customer. Now, to get that set up really fast, I'm going to use the new XLOOKUP function, look up the customer here. Where I'm looking it up is in the customer column. What do I want to get back? I want to get back the company. And in case it's not found because I haven't finished typing in the name or the name doesn't exist, I'm going to put nothing there. Close bracket, press enter, and that's it. I don't need to fix anything here because I'm using table references. So I'm going to copy this down and I get my searchable drop-down list on every single line here together with the company that that customer works at. Well, that's it. That's a simple method you can use to create multiple searchable data validation lists in Excel on the same sheet below one another. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing.